This is a demonstration how we can combine two curves of a street to a three-dimensional curve. The red one is the top view of the street, and the blue one should be the elevation curve of the street. And we want to combine them. So we select both of them and run the script, combine the curves. The result is a three-dimensional curve. It lies above the top view. We see it here. And we look from front view. We see this curve, and I have made of this elevation curve a clone and have rotated it this way. And so from front view, we see both curves are nearly the same, because in this case, the street is straightforward. So when I change the street, let's say the street should make such a curve, then I have to wrap this elevation curve along the street. That means that the hill here must go more to the left side, and the same we have on the right side. So I have done this, and we start the script again. Still, let's see, this was the first result. We run the script, and now we see the whole mountains have shifted to the left, because they must go here along the length of the segments to the left. So what we also can do is we have a mapping, a segmentation of the street. I write such markers, large markers, smaller markers, and so on, very fine markers on the street. We can use this for stationing. And we have the same here on the elevation curve. So the same. These are the markers only. And we also can make a correspondence between these points. It's always so that, for example, this point corresponds to this point. We can also make a relation between the planar projection and the 3D curve this way. So for every control point here, we have a point above here. And the same can be done to this curve too. So what will happen if we change one of the curves? Say we change the elevation curve. In this case, we can say we want to have a big mountain here, and we want to have it a little bit lower on the other side. We close it, the curve has changed, and we rerun the script. So we see the result here. The first mountain is higher, and the second one is a little bit lower. And what we see too is that we do not have used the whole curve of the elevation, because I only need the length of this curve. The length of this curve is this distance. So, and I only use this part and envelop it along this curve. I always need at least the elevation curve as long as the street is. In the other case, I will not get height data. And if I see that the elevation curve is too long, I can change it and can make it shorter. That's all. I also can change always the format of the street. Here, let's make an S-curve. So, these are the new results. And I think we also can go down. Say we use the elevation curve and say we want to have here an area down this way. And then recalculate it all. So, and we see now the street goes to the underground.